Jaime Dempsey, and I'm on a journey to Batanes, one of the most beautiful provinces of the Philippines. There, I hope to experience the unique culture of the Ivatans tribe, a people whose origins are still shrouded in mystery. Getting there means a journey of over 1,500 kilometers, over mountains, across the waves, and through the skies. On this leg of my journey, I'm joining in on a cow chase, learning how to fish the Ivatan way, and immersing myself in village culture when I spend the night in a traditional stone house. My early morning Skyjet flight will take me 1,097 kilometers north of Palawan to the island of Basco Batanes.
Hi, my name is Dino. Dino Chua.
Nice to meet you. What brings you to Batanes?
I'm going to Batanes for business.
Really? What kind of business do you do?
I'm the president of Skyjet Airlines.
What? Really?
Yeah.
That's so crazy. Think of the luck that I have. Well, you're the right person to ask then. How long is this flight?
From Manila to Batanes, it will only take us 1 hour.
That's really quick.
This is actually the fastest flight to Batanes because we're using a jet plane. Other aircrafts and other airlines here are using propeller planes.
I'm going to go riding in Batanes. Do you know any great places I can go? I'm just going to ride around.
There's a great road going to Raku Apayaman. I think you have to visit there and drive your bike.
I want the best views possible, and I hear Batanes is the place to go.
Okay, enjoy.
Batanes, the smallest province in the Philippines, is actually an archipelago made up of 10 islands. The difference in dialect, traditions, and architecture has turned Batanes into an almost mythical land, isolated from the rest of the country, both in geography and in culture. Finally arrived in the northernmost part of the Philippines, the Batanes group of islands, and it would seem I stumbled upon a cow chase. The Ivatan herders all come together to help when a member of their community needs to catch one of his cows. The sense of community here is strong. Everyone's willing to help a neighbor out.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
Jaylung, hi. Do you need help catching your cow?
Yeah.
I'd love to help.
And look my cow over there.
All right, let's see it.
Herding is still done the old-fashioned way, with rope and on foot. Because of the vast land area and the steep terrain, the men have to strategize and work together as a group.
I see a bunch of wild cows. And they're coming towards us. I thought they'd be running away from us. There's little babies, and there's a whole bunch with big horns. So I'm just gonna stay behind Jaylong.
Over there. White, over there. Kailangan kong huliin kasi buntis siya. Kailangan kong alagain para yung anak niya mas maalaga ko.
Once the baby is born, do you bring them both back here?
Yeah.
Hey guys, we found her. She's over here.
Like the rest of the lands in Basco, the Raku Apayaman is government owned and is used freely by the local Ivatans to graze their cattle and other livestock. Before I knew it, the chase was on, and all 20 men were spread wide across the field. The only way to catch the animal, armed with only their ropes and wooden poles, is if they corner it. No easy task in these vast hills.
there, they already captured her. That was super cool to watch all those guys work together to capture one man's cow. And even to let me help. Jaylan let me bring her in, and she was majestic. Her mere size demands respect. Makes me a little nervous to be pulling a cow that's usually roaming free and has those pointy horns. She decided to bolt. I'm just gonna let go. I hope she knows she can trust me. I feel like a real cowgirl right now. This morning's community cow chase has me wanting to know more about the local culture. Lucky for me, a stroll along the shore has led me to meeting a couple of local fishermen. Hi, sorry to interrupt, but what are you guys doing with these poles? Fishing. With these things? I've never seen that before.
Ginagamit ko para sa throw net.
Would you like to show me how to throw a net to catch fish like that?
Yeah, turuan ka namin, turuan ka ng kasama ko.
Okay. So, how do we hold these things? Okay. Move forward. Hold these two on my shoulder. It's like a veil. These are heavy.
Straight siya nang straight
din. This is strangling me.
Yung shoulder mo, kailangan nakabend siya nang ganyan. Parang pasabitin mo dito yung...
This shoulder?
Yeah, yeah, okay. Dahan-dahan lang.
Can I use my hip? I can't lift it. Parang... I know what it's supposed yan. To do, but I can't do it. I don't have the upper body strength to lift this pole right at the end.
Feeling ko technique lang kasi yung hindi mo maka.
Hey, I'm all trapped in the net. I'm the fish now.
Straight. Yan.
I lifted it! Are you getting this? It's up.
Parang pag ganyan.
Oh, I'm not even doing it. Okay. I didn't know I was supposed to.
Tapos, no. Yeah. Stop. Okay, throw this a bit. Forward.
I kind of did it. Come on, don't laugh. Totally a pro now. Let's go fishing.
Okay.
There are at least 20 words for different types of fishing in Batanes, depending on when they're done, the tools used, and the types of fish caught. What I'm trying to learn is manawuy, a traditional style of fishing over 100 years old.
Rachel.
Ow! Ow!
What there?
What? Go!
I may not have caught any fish today, but I did learn a very important traditional way that the Ivatans fish. And I threw the net. At least I did that much. That was a lot of fun. Thank you so much, June. I'm riding through the island in search of a blank book library. A tourist spot where visitors can leave their thoughts and impressions of Batanes. This is one of the coolest little libraries I've ever come across. Hundreds of stories from different people. This one's from someone also named Jamie, spelled the same way, even, which is unusual. Dear God, please always watch over my two kids, well as my husband. I wish more for travel for the four of us. Protect us from harm and guide us. Help us to achieve our dreams and in life. Thank you from Jamie. April 15, 2015. To Mr. Wright, Hi, I've been traveling the world just to see you, to meet you. I don't have any idea how you look like, what's your favorite color, favorite food. I don't know anything about you, but hey, I was looking for you all my life. My advice to this writer is stop looking. The best way to meet someone is to not be looking for them and just live your life. And then before you know it, out of nowhere, you'll meet the right person. I always, when I ride down the street, I look at people that pass by and I always think, what is that person's life like? And here you can read a little bit about them. Oh look, it's a boat. I think that's a falua. One of the local boats. Hopefully I can find one. Well, this entry's on point. This visit has been such a revelation, the innate sense of community and sharing that the Ivatans practice shows such a generosity of spirit that is unparalleled. Everything is done with love and a sense of community and common ownership. It is this culture of sharing and family that'll stay with me when I think of Batanes. And that's true. Since I've been here, I've seen firsthand someone needs help, the community comes together, no questions asked. It's that kind of selflessness that I think the world could use a little bit more of. I think this will be the book I leave my thoughts in as well. From Basco, I'm taking a 45-minute boat ride out to the island of Septang, a municipality that is 15 kilometers southwest of the capital. Visitors come for the breathtaking views and the traditional stone house villages. I love this line. There's so much fun. Here we go! Wait a minute. How am I gonna get back up there? Oh, there's a tricycle over there. Awesome. Hi, guys. You can see it out there. Goats up on the mountain. It's like half Scotland, half Philippines.
Bye.
The Tin Yen viewpoint is an excellent place to stop and take it all in. I kind of see how the geographic isolation from the rest of the country has given the Ivatan people a general air of mystery, something I'd like to break through while I'm here. Chebayan, one of the smallest towns in Septang, and I'm hoping I can find a place to stay the night. Batanes is so far north that it has four distinct seasons, but near enough to the equator to face tropical storms. So the Ivatan have built unique stone houses to withstand the elements. Excuse me, ma'am. I'm looking for a place that offers homestay.
Here is your homestay.
You do? I'm in luck. I'm Jamie.
Thank you.
Auntie Letty, nice to meet you. What are you doing here? What are you making? Is this some headdress? Oh, it's beautiful. Do you mind if I watch you? You teach me how you do it?
Yes. Ganyan mo para mapino.
You brush it, that's how you get it to look like grass.
Try mo na parang dahan-dahan mukha mo.
Very sharp. Just brush like this. It's a little like combing hair.
Pagkatapos niyan, kung natuyo na, ito na.
This one's dried out, and then you split it. So you keep splitting it, so you get a thin little piece
tapos
like that.
Tapos iwid na.
And this is the top of the hat.
Abaca. It's abaca.
Abaca?
Aray mo na.
So it's pulled like this, you're like this. Mm. And then pull. Mm. Yay! I did it!
Amy, tuloy natin mamaya.
Thank you so much. I love these old stone houses. Everything's very rustic and old-looking, but clean, simple, comfortable. And you can't beat this view. It's beautiful. The ocean is right there, palm trees. It's quiet here, peaceful. The people are so friendly. Everybody's smiling when I walk by. And I can't wait to see the stars when they come out at night. I've been invited by Auntie Letty to a community dinner hosted by the local Weavers Association. I'm honored to be a guest at their table, so I'm going to have a little look around to see if I can find anything that can bring us a gift. Excuse me, ma'am. Hello. What is that?
Sugar cane wine. Gusto mo siya matikman?
Try a little bit.
Yes.
Cool.
Lagyan natin ng asin para masarap siya.
Like a margarita.
Oh, tikman mo siya. Masarap yan.
It's cloudy.
Isang taon na yan na reserve.
Mm. Oh, it's good with the salt.
Sarap.
Yeah, very good.
Oh, maraming like salamat.
I really like it. Do you have a bottle that I could buy?
Sa'yo na lang.
Really?
Yes.
Oh my gosh, you're so kind. Where I'm from, if you're invited to dinner, you bring a bottle of wine. And I just found one. Thank you very much. Salamat po.
Everything we're eating here tonight has either been gathered, dug up from the garden, fished from the seas, or hunted from the mountains surrounding the village.
Hello, everyone. Salamat, thank you for letting me join you for dinner, and I brought you some wine. I'll leave it here for you. One of the things I love about Batanes is everything is natural, just the fact that you're using leaves for plates. How many people live in this barangay?
170.
Do you know everyone? Yeah, I don't even know my next door neighbor. Salamat, everyone. I had such a wonderful dinner, and I really enjoyed talking to all of you. I hope I can come see you again sometime. I'm crying.
Dumi, itong iririgalo ko sa'yo. Sa aming proteksyon namin nito sa ingat at sa kasaulan.
Like this? Thank you, everyone!
My name is Jaime Dempsey, and I have come all the way from Los Angeles, California. I've spent the last month riding motorcycles through Mindanao and Palawan. I've suffered a few hardships along the way, but I've met the most interesting people.
Thank you for sharing.
And I've had the best adventures.
I'm the queen of the world!
These adventures have taken me all the way north to Batanes, and I can't think of a better place to end my journey. The view from every single road is spectacular, and it's truly a rider's paradise with all of its twists and curves. Even though many tourists visit here, the land remains relatively untouched, and the old way of life is still alive. It's enough to make anyone that's been on the road this long forget about homesickness. They don't call it breathtaking Batanes for nothing. The Philippine Islands have found a way into my heart. And if you're looking for adventure, this is the country to come and visit. Until next time, it's bye for now. With much love, Jamie.